Okay, let's go move some mountains. I'll start by creating three different mountains. I don't really care much about what shape they are. They just should be just distinctive enough that we know that they're different. So I'll just create like a more cohesive shape. I'll go for three different alpine mountains. You can see they all have different shapes. Let's take the middle one and make it stratified because it'll be alpine enough and then have this extra stuff on top. This is good enough. We'll do more stuff to this soon. So, to move our mountains, the first thing we do is we actually add a transform node to each of them. Go, and then a last one for this. Then I'm going to take all three transforms. I'm going to press F8, or you could right click and select, or you could select all and then right click and combine them into a combined node. So here they're all together. I'm going to switch this to max mode. And what we'll do is I'm going to have all these be different movable ones while locking the preview here. So you right click, lock preview, go here, press Z or press the gizmo button up here. And you take this thing, move your mountain. Go to the other one, press Z again, move your other mountain. And then go to the third one and again and move this one. Actually, I would love for them to be different scales. So I'll go and scale them a bit differently. And I just noticed that the one in the back, oh look, there are these edges. Well, that's easy enough because here you can just quickly select thin edge, wide edge, something like that to kind of null it out at the edge. It's fine if it's looking like this, that's not a big deal. There's a very easy way to deal with this, which is I'm gonna add a ridge. Since the preview was locked, I'll unlock it there. This is a very nice and low ridge. And then I will add it down here as another port. So it's included in this since it's all being maxed. And so that empty area has been filled. If I feel this is not the right one, I can just change the seed, get something flatter like so, go back. There we have it. And going back here, you will see like, yeah, these are different mountains, but they don't really fit that well together. One of the things I want to do, just because the shapes will look cooler, is I'm going to have all three be strata. So we have these cool uplifts on the top. There we go. They also give it a fair bit of directionality. So another cool thing we can do is go to individual ones and rotate them. So like there. This one's going this way, this one's going that way. Not really something we see too much in nature, but hey, why not? Maybe there's a tectonic line right here sending both of them different ways. And then the third one, I'm going to rotate it just a little bit. So like so. And now with all of these, I'll go and create an erosion node. High down cutting, high duration, but low detail. And that's my result. Now I can lock preview here, go down to one of the transform nodes, hit Z, and I can move mountains. And you can see how well the erosion is responding. I can go back here, add coarse sediments, give it a low angle, very high erosion scale. Again, very low detail. Maybe the duration's a bit too high because I'm losing some of the bulk here. But again, go back, press Z, move your mountain. So this is a very quick and easy way to craft large complex terrains by isolating different parts and then merging them like so, and then adding erosion and other effects on top of it. So you're not wasting too much time trying to make these too detailed and realistic. You kind of do all that work here. And so from the ground level, there you go. they may look like three isolated mountain peaks from up here, but then when you go down here, you can see this is already something really great that you can use for a backdrop. So I'll switch this to 4K so we can see it in detail. And in high resolution, you can see we have this beautiful mountainscape. And heck, if you're already here, I'll just quickly add a sat map. Let me find something with a little bit more color, like so, and add color erosion to this. And let's amp up the settings. And so there, we're quickly able to color this mountainscape. We can easily do a lot more just with a few different changes here. If I add more noise, then it's not so clear. Stratification spreads around a bit, then we erode it and make it even nicer shapes.